Our born-again experience began us on a new life on earth, which will end either when our physical body dies or when the Lord Jesus comes, whichever happens first. Until then, the scriptures warn us to live our lives in a manner that we don't lose time on earth, but rather redeem the time by walking in wisdom. That's knowing and understanding the will of the Lord in all areas of our lives and applying them accordingly. From when we are born again to when we go to be with the Lord, all areas of our lives must declare the Lordship of Jesus. For example, you must learn, understand, and apply the Lord's will on earth regarding your relationship with Him. You must know His will regarding your relationship with people. His will regarding your marriage, that is, if you're married. His will regarding the raising of your children, that is, if you have children. And His will regarding your finances or the use of your money. Now, as far as your relationship with the Lord is concerned, the Lord reveals that we were afar off, but because of His blood and our faith in Him, we now have a relationship with God as His children. However, that relationship does not stand alone, as the life of that relationship is in the continuous fellowship with Him, which then drives a life of obedience to His will. Regarding our relationship with people, the Lord has commanded us to love people, even including our enemies, though our fellowship or company with people must be based on truth, as light cannot fellowship with darkness. The Lord also commands us to express that love for people, especially the brethren, by laying our lives down in service to them, that is, doing things that improve others. For those that are married, the purpose, principles, and roles in the marriage must line up with the Lord's word. Your marriage must be a reflection or a testimony of the Lord Jesus and the church. As a wife, you must submit to your husband, and as a husband, you must love your wife as the Lord commands. The wife's role is primarily the homekeeper, while the husband is the worker and provider. If you have children, the words of the Lord Jesus must govern how you raise them. Like the potter and the clay, the parents' touch of relationship, molding through instruction and trimming through discipline, ensures that the child or children are raised in the Lord. The use of our resources, including our finances, must also declare the Lordship of Jesus. We must earn our money, and as the Lord Jesus commanded, must manage it wisely and also give to the needy. When the word of the Lord is applied and lived out in all these areas of our lives, we become fruitful, redeem the time, and truly declare the Lordship of Jesus in our lives till we go to be with Him. However, to successfully pattern all or these areas of our lives according to the Lord's revealed will or His word, we, through the Holy Spirit, must learn to take responsibility for the areas that we may be struggling because of ignorance or simply disobedience. We must be willing to learn and maintain a disciplined life, thus keeping the body under subjection to obedience to these truths in all the different areas of our lives. That is true kingdom living that glorifies the Lord Jesus.